played Chekhov in here? Okay. Who doesn't understand Chekhov and feels like I have no idea what this is and I've truly resisted and I don't want to even go there? That's all right. That's what a lot of people feel. You've seen a lot of bad productions of Chekhov. It's boring. It's dull. You know, I didn't get it for a long time until my teacher, the one I wrote the book about, the actress Chekhov, did dozens of productions of these plays at Williamstown with Blythe Danner and Franklin Jell and all these major actors. Gradually, I started to understand from this perspective of this American company finding an American way to do Chekhov that was different from the Brits' ennui and, oh, God, and we're walking around. And was, so, you know, Chekhov went through a period where it was all very sober and serious and boring. And then the pendulum swung the other way and everybody thought it was a farce because Chekhov said they were supposed to be funny. It's actually this wonderful mixture of comedy and drama that you don't get to do anywhere else, that you don't really see in such a great mix anywhere else. So I believe at Williamstown, over a period of 20 years, this American company of great actors, Christopher Walken, all of these people, worked together on these plays over and over and over, and the basis of my book is they found an American way to do it. Not at the beginning, they all discovered it together over a period of years. So I did this series of interviews with all these different actors who had played the parts. So anyway, that's what my book, The Actors Chekhov, is about. And it's about actors, their experience at Williamstown and their experience with Chekhov and why Chekhov trains you as an actor in a way that that really no other playwright does. You know? The thing that Chekhov gives you, makes it brilliant for actors, are the circumstances. The height. First of all, she has had nothing to eat and nothing to drink. Now think of how we are when we've had nothing to eat and nothing to drink. Second of all, she's been out in the rain. It's a rainy night. She's been walking and walking and thinking, well, you went to where the stage was 2 years ago, and you saw that you're trying to put all the pieces together for yourself. You came back to town. Your father, who lives on the other side of the lake, you can't even go in his home anymore.
Yeah.
They won't, constantly we heard him say, they won't let her come home.
I can't even see where I'm talking about how cozy the space is. Is it because this is home?
Yes.
Ever since I've been here, I've been walking around by the lake. I've been near your house often, and I just couldn't bring myself to come in. Christy, let's sit down. Oh. Please, let's sit down and talk. Talk. Oh, it's warm. It's cozy. You hear the wind? There's a place in Teganyev. Yes. Happy is he who on such a night is under his own roof, who has a warm corner. I see. No. What was I saying? Teganyev. Yes, Teganyev. And may the Lord help all homeless wanderers.
Both of these children were treated, his mother treated him like shit. She was treated like shit.
And I
both of them are so damaged.
And I come to him because he's like my mirror.
No.
Does that make sense? Like he gets me, he can see? Or do I come to him because
you probably...
I know he loves me? And I need someone to love me.
No.
What is it? Why him?
Because
he represents.
He represents
who
the
I was
innocence
and who I'm looking for.
This time I was going.
Nina, listen to me. I cursed you. Yes, I did. I cursed you, and then I hated you.
I tore up all your letters and all your photographs, and then I knew that my heart was bound to you forever. It's not in my power to stop loving you, Nina. Ever since I got my work published and I lost you, my life has been unbearable. I'm miserable. It's as if my youth was snatched from me, and I feel as if I've been living on the earth for 100 years. Do you know that I call out to you? I kiss the ground you walk on. I see your face before me, the sweet smile that shined on me, the best years of my life.
Why does he talk like that? Why does he talk like that?
But every time he starts talking, he says the wrong thing.
Yeah,
see, if you came in and he said, oh God, aren't we older and wiser, and we were never really in love, it was just puppies, you know, it was just a... Then maybe you could relax with him a little more. But he still loves you the way he did then.
Yeah.
And it's like, no, that's not what I need.
Because I hate
what
myself.
I need to hear. Well, no, don't love. Yeah, because I hate myself.
Because I hate myself.
And you haven't... Why do you love me? I never... She doesn't want to say I never really loved you. She doesn't want to say that.
See, Nina, I'm alone. I'm all alone, and I'm not warmed by anybody's affection, and it's cold. It's all cold. It's like living in a cave, and whatever I write is dry, gloomy, bitter. Nina, please, stay here. Stay here. Stay with me. And if you won't, then take me with you. Please.
Nina, why, for God's sake?
Shh! My horses are just out there. I can see myself off. I can manage by myself.
You've got to let yourself be so open. To need for water, to need for food, to need to go and please take me back, to say to him, please take me back. No, I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to.
To go to Trigora.
Yes.
Yes.
To go to Trigora. You've got to.
Everything. I'm having to use all my strength not
all
to run out
your
the door.
Strength.
And
all your strength to not become a suicidal person.
Oh, I'm not late. I hope I'm not late.
No, 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 of course not.
Oh, I worried. I was so frightened. I was afraid my father would
the
let me come.
The whole scene is a back and forth about this for her. I am a seagull. Whether you play it as the loss of the beautiful seagull you once were.
My father and his wife won't let me come here. You see, this is Bohemia. They're afraid I'll go on the stage. I feel drawn to this lake like a seagull.
Or whether you play I Am a Seagull and you identify with the bird Costa killed and laid at your feet.
What does this mean?
I was low enough today to kill a seagull. There, I lay it at your feet.
What's the matter with you?
Soon I shall end my own life this
whether way. You identify with the destroyed seagull or the image of the radiant, pure seagull, both of these images are dangerous for her.
I was born there. I've spent all my life by this lake. I know every little island on it.
Ah, what's this?
Seagull, Constantine, Charlotte.
Beautiful bird.
Either image, the good or the bad, will push her over the edge if she stays there.
An idea occurred to me. A subject for a short story. A young girl grows up beside a lake. She loves the lake like a seagull, and she's happy and free as a seagull. But one day, by chance, a man comes and sees her. And having
the
nothing better to do...
The entire scene, really, is a fight for sanity, destroyed. Moment by moment. In one moment,
like
she drowns,
seagull, yeah?
And in the next, she rises up again.
Seagull, no! Do you remember you shot a seagull? Yes, yes, a man comes by chance, sees it, and out of nothing else to do, destroys it. No,
and
no,
of course,
no,
then
no.
At the end...
Please, what was I talking about?
At least
what
at this
I
point, it's not
about?
Her who commits suicide,
oh,
but Kostya.
The stage.
And then yeah. There was all the problems with the baby, and I was acting badly, and I was this, my life was shit, and then, no, it's not like that. Get me some water. And Blythe did this thing where she's like, water.
Give me some water, please. Give me some water. Give me some water. Please.
Where are you going now?
To the town. Is Irina Nikolaevna here?
Yes. Thursday, my uncle was here. We wired her to come.
Why do you say you kiss the ground I walk on? I had to be killed. No. I'm tired. If I could only rest. I was a seagull. No,
I'm an actress. I'm an actress. He's here too. Oh, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. He didn't believe in the theater, you know. My dreams he would laugh at, and little by little I quit believing in it myself, and I lost heart, and then there was the strain of love and jealousy, the anxiety about my baby. I got to be small and trashy. I didn't know what to do with my hands. I couldn't stand properly on the stage. I couldn't control my voice. You can't imagine the feeling when you're acting and you know it's dull.
She's been walking and thinking as to whether she'll commit suicide or not. But now she's starting to feel herself grow stronger.
And now ever since I've been here, I've kept walking about. I've kept walking about. I've kept thinking, and I've kept thinking, and I keep feeling that my soul grows stronger with every day, Kostya. Yes, and now I know. I understand that in our work, writing or acting, what matters, it's not the fame. It's not the glory. It's not what I used to dream about. It's how to endure. How to bear one's cross and have faith. I have faith. And it all doesn't hurt so much. And when I think of my calling, I'm not afraid of life.
Whether those words are true, she's telling herself, I'm getting stronger, I'm getting stronger, I'm getting stronger. Maybe she'll kill herself 3 years from now, I don't know.
Yeah.
You know, but
yeah.
But she's trying to say, I'm getting stronger.
Okay.
Maybe she'll end up being a prostitute. Maybe she'll, you know?
Who knows, right?
Oh, Kostya. Oh, Kostya. Do you remember how it used to be? How gay and warm and pure our life was. What things we felt. Tender and delicate like flowers. Do you remember?
She hugs, she embraces him. She says, human, do you remember human, lion, eagle, quail?
She does
deer.
The speech.
She does his speech.
From
and
the first.
Then she embraces him and she leaves.
Right.
So that's her looking for her light seagull.
That's the pure.
That's the pure.
Remember how pure love used to be when we did that play and we loved each other
before
time and loss.
Yeah.
The inevitable time and loss came and got us.
Yeah.
Remember how pure life used to be? Remember, wouldn't it be great if life was like that? But it really can't. It can't. It's not. Not after you've had a baby that's died. Not if you've had an affair with a man who left you. Not after acting turned out to be nothing like you ever imagined. No.
I can't. Yeah.
You're a different person. And if you find a way to have confidence and some mastery with Shakespeare, you can do anything you need to do with language. And if you understand how to do Chekhov, you can do anything there is to do with behavior. There's so much incredible behavior to discover in these great scenes. That when I talk about Blythe Danner going around with a water glass and laying down on the couch, I'm so tired, and then you have a canvas to paint with all the colors in this scene as an actor. There's not one color you don't get to use. And in all the many scenes of Chekhov's four major plays, and then there's some one acts, and then there's this Platonov that he wrote early on that's kind of an unfinished play, and he died very young. So there's only four plays. But every one of those scenes, every single one of them, has something huge to offer you as an actor. And actually, there's six plays. There's Ivanov too. Both Platonov and Ivanov are two early ones, so they're not, you know, quite as done as much.
No. Yeah.
So,
So anyway, if anybody wants to pick it up and take it on, feel free, and I'm glad you brought it in Sydney. Eagles and partridges, antlered deer, mute fishes dwelling in water, starfish and small creatures no eye can see. These and all life have run their sad course and are no more. Thousands of creatures have come and gone since there was life on the earth. Now the pallid moon doth light her lamp in vain. In the meadows cranes wake and cry no longer. And the beetle's hum is silent in the linden tree groves.
Oh, I hope no one meets her in the garden and tells Mother. Might upset Mother.
Oh, oh, put the claret and the beer for Mr. Trigorin on that table. Play and drink. Come on, friends. Bring the tea in now.
Mr. Trigorin, here's the thing I was talking about just now. By your order.
I don't remember.